Alright, so Marcy X. Marcy X is not only a comedian, but she is an actress, a musician, and filmmaker in the Prince George's County, Annapolis area of Maryland. She just released her own show online. Please support her by subscribing to her YouTube channel, which is at Funny Lady Mars. That's all one word, including Funny Lady and Mars, like the planet, because she's out of this world. At this time, let's warm up the stage for Marcy A.
Show. Did you prepare for this clean comedy show? I got my shower. Everybody got their shower. All right. I used to be really worried about being able to do clean comedy because I worked at a farm for a while and you get really dirty working at the farm. But I found that like puns just like produced themselves organically. They just like turn up. And I don't care at all how corny that you think that is. I meant to do that. I'm gonna milk this for all it's worth. Please don't have a cow. I hope you can have beef with me. I don't want to run out of time or anything. It beats telling no jokes at all, of course. You know, I don't even kale. It's some of the same points there. I have a lot of jokes about chickens, too, but most of them don't fly. So I have to wing it a lot. That's where I want to go. Let us leave it at that again. I'm sick of the cold. Anybody else sick of the cold already? Ready for summer? Do you like to garden by chance?
No.
We got anybody who likes to garden in the house, plant flowers, maybe? Okay, alright, that's right. We're going to learn some new things tonight. Because working at the farm here, we found this phenomenon that happens every spring. Now, while it's still cold like this, where I don't want to be outside, you know, we get like one warm day, and that's when everybody who likes to garden just like flocks in, and I get a little bit overwhelmed and a little bit uncomfortable because like I am not prepared for just like the mass of people that just rush in and want to get their hands on my plants. And it can be a little embarrassing too because like I'm here I'm like wetting my plants all day, but you know it's like, and the ladies will know what I'm saying here because it's like, look, the greenhouse isn't even, the greenhouse stove isn't even turned on yet, and you know you gotta like warm up the greenhouse before you put in your seeds, so. Lessons learned. Oh man, working at the farm, I don't really work there anymore. The last straw, I think, for me was when a woman asked me, because there's a retail element to it, alright? And I understand, like, a lot of people these days aren't educated about where food comes from, right? But what she says to me is, excuse me, man, there's a problem. There's a problem with this potato. This potato has a problem. Alright, well, what's the problem with the potato? This potato has dirt on it. Yeah, of course it does. No. This potato looks like it has been on the ground. Actually, ma'am, it's been in the ground. Because it's a potato, and that's where potatoes come from. That was the worst of the time. You're still laughing with it. I'm just gonna keep producing puns, just that'll be our whole show. I was responsible for a lot of the flowers as well. I had to trim the roses. I didn't like that I got stuck with that job lot. That really just happened now. That's what I I tried to make it a fun sort of game to, you know, avoid all like the sort of scatting that would happen from dealing with the roses. So I was like, all right, I will make it a challenge. So I called it a game of thorns. I rose to the occasion.
Oh, gracious.
Didn't find yet. I don't just have farm jokes, I swear. Though. What else? Let's see. What isn't a farm joke that we can tell? Okay. All right. So, my love life ain't that great. All right. I am so unlucky in love that I tried to play Hearts on my computer. You know, old-fashioned heart game, okay? On my Windows. It loaded Solitaire instead, and then the game crashed. Oh, blue screen of death right there. So here I am one day at the farm when this hot guy comes in. Really good looking guy. Like I said, here I'm wetting my plants all day. Like when it's windy, plants are on the ground. Plants on the ground. I was looking like a fool with my plants on the ground. You know my style. He's got an accent too. Like, I'm like, Nigerian maybe? I'm like, I don't know, but hello. But he's looking at the mulch, okay? And at the farm, there was like a lot of different colors of mulch. There was like the, you know, the normal hardwood mulch, and there was like a red colored mulch, a black colored mulch. But what he says, what he actually says is the black mulch colored? Oh, how do I answer this question? Look, it does say black color like, right on the bag. But some of it feels wrong to me. Like, maybe I should say, like, no, it's urban. Like, no, it's African American mulch. But he wasn't even American, so I'm like, oh, I'm just ruining this. I'm like, oh my god, is the mulch racist? And then I say, okay, all right, it would only be racist if it was like 3/5 the cost of the white mulch. But then we realized we didn't even sell white mulch, and I felt way worse about that. Oh, I can't win. And then I went home, and Netflix was making documentary recommendations to me, because it's like, haha, you're into agriculture, you like learning documentaries for you, we'll get you some history, here's a new suggestion, like, and it goes, roots! I was like, okay, yes, it is about farming per se. Netflix. You didn't laugh at that joke, you have some shows to be watching to catch up with the history. Oh my gracious. I did children's parties at the farm too. This is funnier when I do the dirty shows. I would give tours around and we would get to, there were chickens at the farm and you know, like there were, it'd be like, okay, we got white chickens and brown chickens, and I'd be like, anybody know the difference? And I'm like, oh gosh, I asked that question in a really bad way, and of course somebody's looking at me like, you about to disappoint me with your answer there? It's like, are you about to say something stupid, like as if I was about to say like the brown chickens had bad credit, but I would never ever do this, it's horrible. It's like, if anything, I would be more likely to say that like the brown chickens are more likely than their white chicken counterparts to be pulled over by police officers. But I would hope that an officer would pull over any chicken attempting to drive. I love your reactions over there. And this is the part where it's like, oh, children's party. So really on a children's store, again, because a lot of people don't know about where the food comes from. And I was explaining that the chickens on the farm, we had only female chickens. And I had somebody like, wait a second, how can you have eggs if you only have girl chickens? And here it is, it's a school, okay, it's a class, there are kids, and like, how do I answer this? So, I go ahead and I just explain it like, okay, well, an egg is actually just a chicken's period.
And you don't need a rooster to have one of those. And if any of what a period is, it's the end of a sentence. And that's your grammar lesson, kids, yes. There is a cat on the farm too, and the kids always like chase the cat around, and like, okay, despite what you may have heard on TV, like if the cat's running away from you, it does not want to be played with. And I always like to use that as like a subtle like way of like teaching consent to children, very, very subtly there. The cat's name was Misk though too. And whenever I saw the cat, I'd be like, oh, I missed you. Cute one in there. We weren't cute for a little, yeah. I like puns. In the back, I got a little container for tea. It's got a cat on it. It's a kit tea. He's just shaking his head. I did two princess parties today. That's where I dress up as a princess for kids' parties. If there are kids in the room, I'm sorry if I ruined it for you that it's an actor doing it, but it's imagination, so it's all fun. The first one today was Alice in Wonderland, and some people asked me about that, and like, oh wow, so you were Alice? Yes, I was, and I was really hungry though too, and it was like a tea party, and you know, you can't have more tea if you haven't had any tea to begin with. And people were asking me, oh, was the white rabbit there? I was like, nope, but we had a brown one. I was like, we don't have a black Santa yet, but we got a brown Easter Bunny. We're making progress here, folks. Oh man. So, but at the other parties, this is where it's fun, because I was also playing a character from the Disney's Descendants, which is all the villains had kids, and we're giving them a chance, because you can't judge kids by the sins of their parents, and I appreciate that lesson. But prom at kids' parties is, and this is best illustrated, I think, by a conversation I had with a banker. Yes, with a banker. And the thing was, I actually majored in criminology and criminal justice, but I'm not about just like arresting people, so I was like, eh, that's not gonna work out, I'd rather just entertain you. But the banker turned out, I mean, actually, the only time I did use my degree was I got to play a detective on TV for like one episode. So, hey, if you watch For My Man out there, I'm gonna be on an episode coming up. Yeah! TV One! He says, I majored in speech and drama. But he says, but we always like to refer to it as screech and trauma. Like, oh, that is a lot like the kids' parties I do sometimes. You know, here I'm dressed up as like Princess Elsa and everything, and like the kids are getting a little bit too wild.
No, no, let go of Elsa's hair. No, no, just let it go, just let it go.
And you know that's also why you can't give Elsa a balloon, right? Because she'll let it go. Hey, we'll go Disney here then. How do mermaids wash their hair? They use Tide. These are all so bad, I know. Oh yeah, how do mermaids weigh themselves? They use scales.
Scales!
Yes, you're doing very, very good. I also joined the Baltimore Murder Mystery Company, and it's pretty killer. So now I have to kill people for a living. It's all for fun. It's not real, you know. Oh, look, he's fine. Everybody round of applause, yay! It is to die for a show, though, not gonna lie. I'm just pulling you in on all of that. These puns are just going. I can't tell if that's the light on me. Or not. Oh, it is. Oh, it is. Well, cool. We could just let it go right there, I suppose, folks, right? Yeah? Well, thank you so much for listening. I had a great time. You are wonderful. I'm funny little Moors. Funny little Moors. I'll just wait here until the next person comes up with the microphone. Angela, we can buy time. I can tell you what my name means. Me, I'm a Marciana. In Espanol, it means Martian. There you go. Me gusta ciencia ficción. Que tengas un buen día.